Hello and welcome back to another Meme History. My name is Mr. Cannon and I'll be your teacher for this lesson. Today we will be taking a look at the Industrial Revolution, a period of modern history in which the civilized world began to use machines, factories, and mills to do the work no one wanted to do. This period of time also sees a spike in child labor. That was me making air horn noises to myself in a room completely alone. Anyways, so to get this started, we are going to look at the birthplace of the Industrial Revolution. England, the home of tea, crumpets, magic, and bad teeth. During the later part of the 1700s, early machines started to be made, most of which relied on water power to move massive wheels and gears. These wooden factories were called mills, and typically were used to make string, cloth, and eventually full clothing. These needs for faster production of clothing came about as a result of a thing known as the Agricultural Revolution, which, while it sounds important, is actually not very exciting. Why? Well, the Agricultural Revolution was not the rise of a carrot king or a broccoli baron. No, far simpler. It was the invention of fences, iron tools, and the use of easy-to-grow crops, like corn and potatoes. This led to an explosion of population. This population was fueled by these new technologies and these new ways of making farms do better. So with more people and farms doing better, you don't really need that many farmers. So what do you do with these farmers? You send them to the mills, these early day factories made out of wood. Luckily, within the next 30 years or so, around the time of the 1800s, real factories started to form, fueled by coal. No longer was wood the sole source of fire that they could easily use. Coal had become a hot product, easy to mine and easy to find in England, so much so that it turned these mills into what we would again know as common day factories. Able to burn longer and hotter, it was also used with iron to make steel, which in turn allowed for taller buildings, longer bridges, these better forms of transportation that we'll talk about later. England had plenty of coal and iron, so much so that it quickly began to outproduce every other country in the world at this time. With so much money to be made off this new product, this new use of steel, more and more factories started to pop up, offering jobs to those now leaving the farms. Unfortunately, these conditions were harsh. These jobs, while they were easy to come by, paid terribly. Often men would net maybe $2 a week. Women would make far less, normally making half of what the man is making. Children, too, would make even less. Yet, they were able to support their families in ways they never could have if they had stayed at the farm. Men, women, and children worked in mines, factories, smiths, all in order to produce new steel tools, iron tools, all these manners of new tools and machineries that was needed for the Industrial Revolution. Most foregoing or giving up an education just for a small paycheck. Children that worked in coal mines would often get sick from breathing in the coal dust, most never reaching an age past 33. Women had to cut their hairs in factory lest they would run the risk of losing their head, or even worse, the rest of their body. There was no social security. There was no safety net for people who would get maimed or hurt by these things. So there was no hope if you had gotten hurt. The hours, too, were long. Often you would start working at 5 or 6 o'clock after you walked to the factory in the morning. You would most likely end about 6 o'clock, which again you would walk home from the factory. Breaks nor weekends were a thing at this point. In most homes these workers could at least afford were nothing more than a 1 or 2 bedroom apartment. You would be lucky if you shared this apartment with 8 to 10 people. Bathrooms, you might be asking? Well, these workers who lived in these apartments were again lucky if they shared a single bathroom with 20 people on the same floor of their new apartment building that they were living in. Yet for all the horrors of the industrialization, there was a silver lining. New inventions made life somewhat better. Steam engines, steam cars, steam trains, better medical tools, new procedures in medical, typewriters, telephones, indeed anything you can probably think of probably has its roots in industrialization. Of course, England and all the other European nations that started to copy it needed to fuel this. So they came up with this new idea called imperialism. Basically, they were going to look at these quote-unquote uncivilized parts of the world and strip them for their natural resources, their coal, their iron, anything that they could use to help fuel their industrialization. But this is a story for another time. My name is Mr. Cannon, and I hope you have actually learned something. But above all else, I hope you guys have had a solid day.